We welcome you to enjoy this Blackstone audiobook from ABDO Magic Wagon, books that kids love in the classroom. Get ready for an amazing listening experience that connects the school library to your home and keeps the learning going.
A Misfit's Life for Me, The Jinx, by Jan Fields. Illustrated by Alexandra Barboza. Published by Magic Wagon, a division of ABDO. Chapter 1. Runaway. Smack! 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 The stick struck Matron's hand over and over. Come out, girl! Come and get what's coming to you! It'll only get worse if you make me wait! Elizabeth huddled in the dark space between the stove and the wall. She would not come out. She would not be hit. Not for an accident. It wasn't my fault, she whispered. Her voice barely stirred the darkness. I didn't mean to drop the teapot. A rat ran up my skirts. The other orphan girls had giggled when Elizabeth slapped at her dress. No one laughed when they saw the dent in the teapot. They knew what it meant. They'd all felt the smack of Matron's stick. Elizabeth decided she was never going to feel it again. She bolted from her hiding place and raced by Matron. A heavy hand caught the back of her ragged dress. Elizabeth struggled. Her scraggy shoe struck Matron's leg. The big woman howled and let go of Elizabeth in surprise. Elizabeth raced out the door, running down street after street in a blind panic. Matron hobbled after her. But she was too old and too slow. Elizabeth ran until the stench of dead fish made her gag. She was at the docks. Everyone knew dangers lurked there, but she didn't care. She looked at a ship bobbing in the water. All Elizabeth saw was escape. Chapter 2. Out of the Frying Pan. Elizabeth had hidden on the ship through weeks of anxiety. Now all the hiding seemed pointless. The ship would soon be torn apart by a storm. Elizabeth clung to a heavy crate. Around her, the ship groaned in the storm. The floor under her feet tilted and rolled. Icy water poured in from cracks all around the ship's hold. The floor tilted again, slamming the crate against Elizabeth. She whimpered from fresh pain. Then she heard loud voices. Frozen in fear, she peered toward the door. Don't come in! Please, don't come in! The door to the hold flew open. Two men staggered in. They saw her as they were inspecting the boxes.
A stowaway!
One burly man shouted.
It's a girl!
The other rushed toward Elizabeth.
It's a jinx!
The men were wet to the skin. They marched Elizabeth out into the storm and pushed her to the deck.
This is why the storm attacks us,
one of them shouted.
A stowaway is a jinx! Throw the jinx overboard!
It's our only hope!
Elizabeth looked around at the angry faces. My luck is running out, she thought. Chapter 3. Into the Storm. A tall man approached through the angry crowd. He wore a fine wool uniform.
What's going on here?
A pirate shouted over the storm.
We found a stowaway, Captain!
The crew pressed close.
A jinx! She'll drown us all!
He glared back at them.
Get to your posts! We need every man working to save us!
Not one crewman turned back to his work.
Throw the jinx overboard!
One man snarled.
Throw her overboard!
Another yelled. Soon all of them had taken up the call. The captain looked around at his crew. Then he turned to Elizabeth. She saw regret in his eyes. He would not save her.
Give her a lifeboat,
the captain demanded.
With water, set her adrift.
The crew grumbled about the waste of a boat. But then the captain drew his sword. The crewmen scattered like rats. The pirates put her in a small boat.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.